Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about physical and chemical changes. In the previous chapter we have learned about a few physical properties of matter, the properties of matter that can be observed and specified like color, hardness, rigidity, fluidity, density, melting point, boiling point, etc. These all are physical properties. The physical changes which we observe during the interconversion of states of matter like solid, liquid, gases. Solid converted into liquid, liquid converted into gas. These look different. These have different physical properties that we have learned in the previous chapter. But chemically these all are same, as we take the case of water, because water in the solid state is also chemically it is water, in the liquid state also it is water, and in the gas state also it is water. That means they look different, they have different physical properties, but chemically these are same. So what we can say that the interconversion of states of matter is a physical change, because these changes occur without change in the chemical nature of the substance. Like the case of melting, boiling, chopping, shredding. These all are the physical changes, because all these processes does not involve or does not make any chemical changes in the substance. So these are called as a physical changes. Next is the chemical changes. When we take the case of water and the cooking oil, because these both nearly look same as these are liquids. So we observe that these nearly look similar because both are the liquid. So we expect that these have same physical properties, but these are different in the order and chemically these are different. So we observe that as these look similar, but they have different chemical properties. As we know that oil burns in air, but water extinguishes the fire. That means these are not chemically similar one. So in the chemical change, one substance react with the other substance to form new substance, and this is also called as a chemical reaction. So this is actually, we can see that chemically these are different. So what we can say that the change in which one substance react with the other substance to form a new substance, that is called as what? Chemical change. So very important point is that here a new substance is formed. That change is called as chemical changes, and this is also called as a chemical reaction. When we take the examples of chemical changes, like we observe in our day-to-day life, the process like burning, rusting, digestion of food, photosynthesis, all these actually are the chemical changes, because during this procedure a new substance is formed, and that is actually called as a chemical change. The chemical change can also be called as the chemical reaction. So whatever the examples we can see in this picture, like burning process is a chemical change, because when we burn something, that means the substance what it is present in that is reacting with oxygen present in the air, and it forms a new compound. So we can say that the burning process is called as a chemical change, because there is a new substance is formed. The similar one, rusting of iron, because rusting of iron is resulting in the formation of new compound here. That is actually the chemical change. And these all actually are the change in which new substance is formed. That is called as chemical changes, which can also be called as chemical reaction. So when we take the example of the wood which is broken down, that is a physical change because here new substance is not formed, but the burning of wood is called as a chemical change. So this can be very well explained, the difference between the physical change and the chemical change, because in this procedure there is no new compound formation is there. That means there is no new substances formed here, but here the new substances formed. That is a chemical change. So when we differentiate between the physical and chemical changes, we can write in this way: a chemical change, a change or the chemical reaction which forms a new product. But in the physical change, the matter changes form, but not chemical identity. Does not changes the chemical identity. That means no new substances formed. So these are the difference between physical and chemical changes. Now we can write the difference between these in this way, that is, physical changes are mostly reversible, but chemical changes are not reversible. No new substances are formed here. One or more few substances are formed, and here the substance retain its chemical property, and the new substance formed have different properties from the original substance, that is in the chemical changes. And in the detail about the chemical changes, that is about the chemical reaction, you'll be going to learn in the further classes. So this is all about this video. Have a nice day.